are best of two. This is an interesting lineup coming in from both teams. And when I'm throwing it to the casters, I only ask for one thing, and one thing only. Show mercy. With that being said, Naisu, Mirko, you guys can have it.
Thank you so much, LaFell. We'll see if we can have some mercy here for this matchup. It's the ALJ match of the day. The match between the rulers of Group C. Trying to get that top spot. Once again, I'm Naisu and joined here on desk with Mirko. And we'll be bringing you the last match of day number three here for MSC at EWC as we round out Group C to find out where they fall into place as we jump into the Land of Dawn. It's homeboys from Malaysia and Team Liquid Echo from the Philippines. Will be the homeboys or the cavalry to start out game number one. Looking at everything falling into place, of course, emblem-wise as well. You got Chibi once again running the Roger. I love the Roger in the jungle with the Warcry.
I love it, the Warcry. We were actually talking about where the Roger's gonna go, where the Lunox's gonna go. Yeah. I was like, okay, maybe we get a Fire Flux here, maybe we get the Lunox in the jungle, but it turns out, no. All right, Nets is gonna be on it in the gold lane, and hey, it's really cool to see, you know, for this matchup especially, Nets, back when he was playing for MPLPH, you know, for ONIC-PH, he said that, you know, he's the best goal laner, and now we technically get to see that if he has improved that much. Udil gonna be engaged on Zoran as well, getting that Jeet Kune Do. We'll see him tested up against Benny QT after transferring the homeboys. He hasn't really had the chance to go up against a lot of Filipino gold laners.
Yeah, it's been a while, I'd say, for Nets. So there's this matchup alone, there's so much to talk about here. Even the fact that this time around, Carl Teezy went with the Boxer pick, which actually ends up, you know, working pretty well against the Angela that homeboys went with. You know, leave it to homeboys, by the way, to go ahead and bring a draft like this to the table. Top side, Sapat should be fine. Does get quite low, but it goes, has that passive as well. The body of Smith there to keep him alive a little bit longer, and it will not go down just yet. I think the other thing you have to point out too is Zorn on this choke pick. We saw how good this can be back in the wild card stage, Mirko.
Mm-hmm, we did, man. Zorn, not even just the wild card, even just earlier, we saw how lethal Zorn can be on the choke. When he finds, you know, the jam, his momentum, it's very, very hard to actually get away from him. He's a very annoying player on the choke, especially. I think I would say on anything that can actually initiate. So 50% of Mobile Legends heroes.
I was going to say, that's quite a big pool of heroes that can initiate, but Turtle's going to be initiated already, but Carl Teezy is going to start that up. Trying to get that level four for homeboys, but they might be a little bit too late to the fight here. Zorn doesn't have it either.
Mm-hmm. He does have the Shunpu, though. He's going to go over to Jeet Kune Do all the way to the back line. Chibi winning out of the retreat battles. Carl Teezy was stunned up in a penalty zone. Sapat's going to hammer down to Sanji. Picks up the kill. That's first blood over. Chibi will not be able to escape. Liquid Echo, they say it's fine. Get the turtle, we'll take the kills.
Yeah, Liquid Echo does not matter to them. Oh, hold on. Do they? Okay, they get the brilliance out. Some extra shots coming out as well, but Liquid Echo, because of the fact that they were able to get those two kills loaded as well on Sanji here, that's gonna help them out in the damage department and then play around the power spikes that come pretty early on if you look at this. And that's why I'm wondering, for Nets picking up this Lunox, you know that that can overload the damage department early on, but even with the, how the last fight went, Zorn is still doing what he does best. Just showing, oh, hold on, mid lane.
Force the flicker out, Udil.
Wow.
LaFell was already talking about this pick right in the mid lane. It's kind of concerning to see Udil on a pick like this when usually he wants to go on the carries. If it's not the Valentina, you definitely see a lot of that Farsa. And we did get to see that just before match number three. In match number two, when he played together with Zorn on the Cho. So it's already very interesting to see him now on a passive, reactive pick over the carry rolls or over the proactive picks that we're used to seeing. But even Benny Cutie, you can see. Now I feel like for the Beatrix, back in the day, we always expect the Beatrix to go for a pure 1v1. You know, like she's the dueler, she's the duelist. But now it's more of a non-lane whenever you're up against a Beatrix. All he does in the lane is clear wave. That's
clear wave.
And then rotate over to the mid lane, does the same thing as well.
Yeah, pretty much. You know, and at this point, honestly, if you're going to pick the Beatrix up, now again, we saw this get the Savage before, what was that, on day one, I think it was, with CW. But it's still a hero that has a tool for every situation, and sometimes that might just be clearing waves for a while, getting that gold lane experience. Sanji, though, used that feathered airstrike. I don't think Chibi's not going to be able to follow. Heart guard was actually used, too, so it looked like some miscommunication there from homeboys.
For sure. I think Udil's call was definitely, you know, go in, I can get you the heart guard, but Chibi wants to play it a bit safer. He knows here, Zorn, able to go for the kick onto the way of the dragon. Wrong angle, though. Sanford jumping in with Onward and the Earth Shatter. Now with the Primal Wrath, Chibi castled out of the Light Compound. Zorn going to be getting rid of in the back line, and that's a turtle again this time for Liquid Echo as they dominate game number one in the first 4 minutes.
My goodness, who let the cavalry out here in game one against homeboys? And time again, as people have been watching homeboys, they've been like, man, they're looking good. But right now, Liquid Echo is just dominating the early game. That time around, they also managed to get the objective. They got the turtle, they got some kills, and a bunch of extra gold as well. Look at this, Benny Cutie just picks up the BOD this early on.
BOD in the fifth minute of the game. We were talking about how much of a menace he is just clearing out these waves. Zorn, again, up top, really trying to be annoying here for Sanford, trying to delay him into the lane, and that actually does work out very, very well for homeboys. Sapat is able to get so many hits on the turret, so at least it'll be a trade. Bottom lane tier one for the top lane tier one as Udil claims that flask of the Oasis. Now Zorn gonna go for the way of the dragon again onto Carl TZ, not able to find it just yet, but now finds himself in the proper angle to go for it. The way of the dragon onto Sanford, though, no one's there to follow it up. It's actually gonna be TLP. Angel rotate faster, Benny Cutie rotating and getting the kill on Zorn, punishing the guy who was meant to go for pickoffs.
Yeah, I think again you're playing the Cho. Oh my goodness! What is that damn? That's big damn!
Benny, my goodness! Have some mercy, LaFell said to the casters, but maybe he should have said it to Liquid Echo. 7-0, 6 minutes
Benny.
In.
What? All he has is the BOD and that Fury Hammer. I mean, a little bit of extra damage, but my goodness, the damage department is already there for a Liquid Echo this early on. And I mean, everything that they just managed gives them that 5,000 gold ahead in terms against homeboys. And homeboys, you know, Zorn, what he was trying to do early on, trying to find a pickoff, is going to be increasingly more difficult now because of the gap that you're seeing here in terms of items. He's going to have to be much more calculated in the approach to deal with this. Turtle, I think this is just for the taking for Liquid Echo.
The first turtle, homeboys was able to contest it. They were able to get a really good steal. And then the next two turtles, it was just, you know, pure domination for Liquid Echo, able to control it, set up properly as well. And this time, no contest at all. Zorn trying to go for the way to dragon, but again, Sanford, I don't really think he's the right target to go for. Now with Carl TZ with a shield unity, Sapat, Udil, everybody from homeboys, they can't even step foot in their own jungle.
Sanford's doing such a good job at being that front target, because do you really want to kick an Edith towards your team? You know,
no.
I mean, she's just going to pop the Primal Wrath, and then it's a disaster from there. For homeboys, that's the thing. We kind of have to look at where can they find hope in this game already, falling further and further behind. It looks like they use Concealed down there, but it's only Carl TZ. He goes for Sanford.
They're going to go on to Sanford now with the Chaos as well. Sanford just walks up with the Onward, has the Primal Wrath, flickers back again. 2v5 in the bottom lane. Sanford sustaining in, but will finally be taken out by Zorn. Now with Sanji rotating as well. That's a feather airstrike to deal some damage. Chibi getting rid of Carl TZ, but now Benny Cutie, the big damn carry, is here. The raid boss looking to go for the cleanup.
Benny.
The Bennett's Rage not in range. Zorn with the Jeet Kune Do. Great disengage, and homeboys will be able to capitalize on that 2v5.
There you go, homeboys. That's what. No, the shot's gonna land, but it's not enough to
calm
get the kill. But homeboys, they get it. At least they get back in the game. I was asking the question, where's the hope for them? And it looks like they're still going.
Way the dragon into the Chaos JP. Still able to flick around now with the bloom and the feathered airstrike chunking them down. Sanford looking for a re-engage. Zorn recalls in front of them. And Benny gets the shotgun out. Don't be recalling in front of me, man.
Oh, anytime you see that, you have to be careful. We already saw the preview of the damage that Benny Cutie's holding on to. If somehow homeboys can get to Benny Cutie, that'd be great pickup for them. But already, now the Lord is up. I would say, you know, with what happened for homeboys in that whole exchange, I'm not sure if it's enough to actually go toe-to-toe contest when it comes to the Lord here against Liquid Echo, but so far, at least they find a little bit of hope. The Nets is a big part of that. He hasn't gone down. He's been able to farm up. Zorn's going to take some damage, though.
Chain CC. Zorn, baits out the feathered airstrike, too. Very early on Sanji. And now he'll be forced to recall. He doesn't have a lot of mana, but it does seem like he's actually going to choose to stay around the Lord Pit. Angela in the bottom lane trying to go for that macro advantage with wave clear. With the global presence, Sapat has the penalty zone. Can go for the chain CC onto Carl Teezy, but Carl Teezy goes over shielding and Ichibi walking in and he wins it! Now with the Rectory battle one, Sapat jumps in deep into the back line. Sanford gonna be able to still tank in so much damage in the front, soaking it in, but ultimately will have to disengage. They can't go for more. Homeboys, great steal. Zorn, Way the Dragon, bringing Bandit Cutie back into the wild. Oh, Lycan pounce. But the Feather Airstrike isn't able to take him down just yet now. And Homeboys, again, another amazing pick.
This is a massive swing now for Homeboys. They've evened out the gold. They got big shutdowns as well, plus the objective. What more could Homeboys ask for here? And with that, you're seeing the items being locked in as well. Glowing One also picked up from Udeal, wants to help with that sustainability coming out there. They have the floor in for Liquid Echo. They should be able to make quick work of this Lord. Nothing too crazy should happen off this, but what that's done for Homeboys is given them a fighting chance to now get space to work with on the map.
Great space to utilize now, but Carl TZ, oh, good shampoo by Zorn with the TPs. I think the Wood Sandstorm, you know, he asked the question. Now, we definitely got to get someone in production or maybe the analyst to count how many TPs he's doing because Zorn is already finding his jam now in the 10th minute of the game. It took him a while. Usually, we see him TP very early on.
Yep.
Now, Zorn is getting it in the 10th minute. But let's talk a little bit about the scaling of both these teams, right? Because for Homeboys, with the Lunox, with the Roger, they actually have some proper scaling to play with.
They do, and that's why I was mentioning it earlier with Nets. You know, for the most part, as he, mid lane.
Shield Unity into the Poisson. Chibi still able to evade from the Feathered Airstrike. Zorn pops in to conceal. Still no full initiation. Zorn wants to go for it, jumps in with the Jeet Kune Do. Shunpu's back out as Sanford pops into Earth Shatter. Both teams playing it slow, resetting.
He's doing such a good job at, even if it's just baiting out the Feathered Airstrike, that's what Homeboys need. So Zorn now, like you mentioned, getting to the point in the game where he's able to kind of relax a little bit, get these, you know, these ultimates down if he can, maybe a couple battle spells as well. And that's part of it. Going back to Nets here, looking at the items, he's getting there. He's already got the Genius Wand, Divine Glaive, Enchanted Talisman. He's got his three locked in. And that actually works really well, even in conjunction with having an Angela there to help you out. So we'll have to see, again, the damage potential from this Lunox picks later on. Oh, they jump in.
Mm-hmm. Onward, Earth Shatter. Try to time the Shunpu. Not that time, Zorn. Unfortunate for him. He gets sniped down by the Renner's Apathy. Liquid Echo now utilizing that advantage. Try to go for the Siege in the mid lane. Nets trying to go for the clear, not able to do so. Sapat will just give it away as they send Udeal up top. Sapat?
Is he going to get cut off?
He's going to be cut off. I think he was trying to get through the wall, but the purple buff spawned. So it cut his escape off, forced the flicker out there.
And at least, you know, he's alive, but he had to utilize the flicker, so that's not available for him now. And so with that, he doesn't have this impossible engage tool to go ahead and fight off into this Lord, but Chibi's going to start it up. Actually, really front-sided this. Sapat now part of the fight, too, the rest of them as well. Zorn going in with Conceal.
Mm-hmm, trying to bait out that Purify from Sanji, but it stays with it. JP going to be scratched down by Chibi just a bit, forcing the flicker out as Carl TZ uses the Tortoise of Poissons, losing all of his mana. Feather Airstrike by Sanji to poke them down. Slowly but surely, the Lord reset it. Zorn again, now inside. Way the Dragon, used up by Zorn, and he's forced to flicker. Ritter Shatter by Sanford, right into Benny QT, who follows it through. One man advantage for Liquid Echo. As they play around, Nets jumps in with the Chaos, unable to find Sanji. The Bloom comes in at Sanford. Again, finds the Onward right into the Shield Unity to change CC Chibi, but he's still able to escape now with the Penetrate not connecting. Nets gets the Brilliance off just in time, but Sanford is able to catch him just in time as well. Liquid Echo, though, secure the Lord. Benny on the Renner tries to go for the snipe. There's no one there for him. Homeboys, they gotta give it away.
My goodness, I know we have said multiple times that the Lord Dance has changed. It's not technically a dance anymore, but it's more like a puzzle. It's more like a board game because, man, Liquid Echo played that like chess. They bobbed and weaved within that zone. They got the ultimates out. They re-engaged when they had to disengage at first, and then they came out picking off the right targets, giving them the Lord, and now giving them this advantage as they get ready to approach the base here. Homeboys, though, fully lined up, should be able to at least hold on possibly some of the base turrets if they can withstand the initiation from Liquid Echo.
They still have a Lunox, but Liquid Echo have a Farsa. Feathered Airstrike, that's all they needed to zone them away. Odile. And Odile, oh no! Udo in the bottom lane pops into hard guard and will be able to escape. Carl Tizzy didn't have the shield unity that time. It's a great distraction. JP, what? Caught all alone. Sanford brings him back to the team. Overextended. What?
Why was he there?
Why was he there?
Well, with that, Liquid Echo. They know they can go in.
Shield Unity, Sanji flying by. Udil forced to flicker on the Feather Airstrike inside of the base. Udil still able to get out. Nets going to be chunked down as well by that Feathered Airstrike. Three base turrets taken down with one big mistake from Chibi.
Zorn. Can he do something?
The saving grace goes on the Pedicute. He finds the engagement with Raiders, drag him to the penalty zone. Locks him down for nothing. Nets is unable to get them. It's only JV gets taken now. Benny is able to kite away. Zorn has to conceal, but he's unable to find anyone else. Now it's a killing spree as Benny goes into the Menace Rage. Sanford with the final round, not following down, trying to go for the mobility. The Feather Airstrike there, taking Nets out. Zorn has the Jeet Kune Do. One last snipe. Zorn able to evade from it with the Shun Poo. Gets immobilized, but is still able to run away. Homeboys, they're able to defend, but three base turrets have been taken away from their base.
They hold on to the game, but man, again and again, Liquid Echo really showing the prowess in terms of team fighting, even into this base. It's amazing that Pedicute was able to survive that last exchange, even when Zorn awaited so long for that initiation. He did have to use that flicker, but he's 7-1 right now. Just had that one death earlier on when he was shut down, but so far it's been really difficult for homeboys to find the answer. How do we get to Pedicute? How do we get past, even once that artillery is set down with the Feathered Airstrike? And that's really what's just working so well for Liquid Echo in the lineup that they have here. And my goodness, Sanford on this Edith pick. She's been a hero that has played its role, played its part so many times for so many teams, but in the hands here of Sanford, really just kind of difficult for homeboys to get past, even when he pops that Primal Wrath form. So Lord up once again, homeboys resetting, readjusted. Their base is fully exposed. They have to keep an eye on the possibility of what we've seen the Liquid Echo do time and time again. And the Lord is now up. Liquid Echo will go ahead and approach this. Meanwhile, Udil is planted topside. But I'm not sure if homeboys really wants to contest this Lord here.
Doesn't seem like Liquid Echo are gonna go for a full commit just yet, but they do, just with a few more shots. Zorn concealed to the back line, trying to go for it. Sanford will be able to secure it. Now it's gonna be Chibi again, caught in the front. Gets sniped down by Benny. Just with the basic attack, he dealt that much damage. Benny chasing him down. Zorn still able to escape with the Jeet Kune Do. Look at Sanford with the Primal Wrath. Benny trying to cut him off, and it will be JP with a flicker forward. Zorn will not be able to take this damage. Sky Piercer for Benny. The TPs start counting them from Liquid Echo as they take Zorn down. Five members strong with a big Lord in the mid lane.
They'll wait for it. Lord walks in with them, and the cavalry is here, and they're looking to close out the game.
That's a four-man penalty zone right into the Winter Crown, but what is it for? They're gonna be gunned down by Benny QT, who's an absolute monster in game number one. TPs all across the board as Liquid Echo take the lead.
And the cavalry is out, and the crowd goes wild with them.